If you want to know what's going on in Rockingham County government, check out Rockingham County 411. If you're interested in county governmental programs, projects, and services, don't miss Rockingham County 411. Public Information Officer Mabel Scott will share important, crucial news you can use with Rockingham County 411.
Rockingham County 411, you're in a good place. I'm Mabel Scott, your Public Information Officer, and today we're talking with our Interim Public Health Director, Susan Young. Susan, we've been hearing over the last couple of days there have been an uptick in the number of cases across the state.
Mabel, yes, there has, and it's really been across the whole entire state. There's really some areas that have a greater uptick than others, but it seems to be spread across. And of course, you see other states are having the same increases that North Carolina has had. Thankfully, our case counts here within the county have not risen proportionally, so that's a good thing.
Good. Well, summarize, give us an update. What do we do right now?
Right now, we just keep doing the three W's, wear the mask,
yes.
Stay at home, wash your hands, mm-hmm. Socially isolate, just stay with your family, avoid social gatherings, large gatherings, you know, go do the things that you need to do to provide food and pay your bills and things like that, but do not do any social gathering any more than you have to do. So that's very important.
Now the holidays are right around the corner, so what about that?
That will be more information coming down, and I guess it just depends on the trajectory of our case counts.
Okay.
It depends on if it's going higher, it's increasing, are we stabilizing, do things look better? I guess that will be looked at on usually a two-week basis. So when we get closer to Thanksgiving and the holidays, we will be hopefully in a better place.
Good. Let's hope and pray that happens. As far as Rockingham County is concerned, if we've had some increases, where exactly have they been? Are there specific locations in the county?
Right now, we have 1,644 cases here within the county. The highest case counts are in Reidsville, followed by Eden, Madison, and then Stoneville. But there's no what we call a hotspot occurring right now. There's no one set area, there is no one set place. Our nursing homes have kind of calmed down. We're not seeing big increases in the nursing home cases. Thank goodness, that is a good thing.
Demographics, do we see any patterns?
No, we haven't had any, knock on wood, any clusters this week. We haven't even had a death this week, which is good for Rockingham County. That is a blessing.
It is.
We had, when the schools reopened a little bit, we had a couple of clusters in the schools, but this week that has seemed to calm down too. And our ages, the highest percentage is 21-year-olds seem to be our highest percentage right now, followed by 44-year-olds, and then 55 to 56-year-olds, and then 61 to 62-year-olds. So there's no real, it's spread across the spectrum. Exposure types are still, family social is the highest, then nursing home was second, workplace exposures were next, and then unknown was the next one. That comes from the community spread and socialization.
Dr. Mandy Cohen mentioned in her remarks about some challenges in some parts of the state where people were not able to get all the information they needed from patients who had tested positive, as far as sharing information that you all need in public health.
Right, I think in the beginning, because they were getting a call from their local public health individuals, it was very, I think, personalized. They knew the area codes, they knew the phone numbers, they knew it was probably the health department calling. They were expecting that call. And now I think the calls are coming from the contact tracers that have been hired by the state, but that is a necessity because they are actually following close to 7,000 people in Rockingham County right now for us. And there's no way with our limited staff of three that we could handle that much contact tracing. So it is needed, but please, if you see a number, please, that you don't know, I know a lot of people on their cell phone, don't answer a number that they don't know, please answer that. Or if they leave a voicemail, do just check that voicemail out and call them back and get into contact tracing. That is what kind of decreases the spread, and that's what we want.
The information is confidential.
Yes, we do not share information. Your information is not shared. Even if, you know, we have people to say, well, who said I was positive? Who is the positive person? We don't even tell that. So it is very confidential, and we just say, you know, you're a known exposure. And that kind of goes along with the Slow COVID app. That is the thing you can download on your phone, and that just tells you if you've been into contact with somebody who is a positive case. If everybody had that on, your phone would ding and you would know automatically you have been close to someone or in that exposure window.
Also, the weather is changing. The flu.
The flu is here. Unfortunately, we had our first case in Rockingham County, I think last week, of co-infection of flu and coronavirus. The person recovered and was okay, but it is here and it can happen. So please, everyone, go out and get your flu shot. Flu shots are available here at the Rockingham County Governmental Center. Public Health is giving flu shots on Tuesdays and Thursdays. And that time is 9 to 4:30, and it is a drive-through clinic. You will see a big marquee sign out there at the entrance with the hours and telling you where to come to. Tuesdays and Thursdays, you can just drive through. It's very simply done, easy. You don't even have to get out of your car.
That's convenient.
Yes. And for elderly folks who have limited walking ability or who use a cane, who use a walker, it is very helpful for them.
It is. Anything else we can do during these winter months as we get ready to deal with a lot of changes?
Just continue the 3 W's. That is very important, and that's what we just need to continue to do. It will work with flu, it will work with COVID, it'll work with the common cold virus. If you just stay away, wear your mask, wash your hands, don't socialize as much as normal during the holiday season, and hopefully things will get back to normal sooner than later. There is still a vaccine on the horizon. I know you're hearing a lot about that in the news, so it still is on the horizon. We are still planning here in Rockingham County to get that vaccine and distribute it. It should be coming in first to healthcare workers, long-term care facility residents, EMS workers, but it will hopefully eventually flow out to everyone.
You've heard it first from our interim public health director here in Rockingham County. Thank you so much to Susan Young for her entire team. They have been working, and we appreciate all that you and your staff have done over the last few months. Everybody's been on roller skates since February and March.
Absolutely. And Mabel, I did want to mention one other thing that will begin on Monday.
Okay.
So the state is going to take over our COVID testing and create a new testing site here. It will be on the Governmental Center campus. It will actually start Monday at 12:30, and you can drive through and get your COVID-19 test here. Similar to others that are, you know, within the county, you do need to schedule an appointment. There is a link, and that will be shared. And if you do not have internet access or you're registering for a minor, there's a telephone number you can call to do that. But if you don't have, you know, you can just drive up. It will take a little longer to complete some paperwork if you do it that way. But we will be open and be available to do COVID testing Monday, Wednesday, and Friday from 8 to 5.
And this is free again?
It is free of charge. Anyone who meets the testing criteria can be tested. It is through OptumServe, and it is a community testing site. If you're uninsured, underinsured, undocumented, or homeless, you can still come. They will give you an identified number. Usually you have to provide a driver's license number, but if you don't have a driver's license, they will assign you a number and you can still be tested. They have broken down a lot of the barriers for testing and are trying to make sure that everyone who needs a COVID-19 test can be tested.
We appreciate that.
Yes.
Everything you ever wanted to know about COVID-19, Susan Young, our interim public health director. Thank you so much again, Susan.
Thank you.
And we'll see you next time.
All right.
Rockingham County, 411. You're in a good place.